Key English Test 4 by University of Cambridge ESOL Examinations in conjunction with Cambridge University Press. This recording is copyright. This is the Cambridge Key English Test. Paper 2. Listening. Test number 1. There are 5 parts to the test. Parts 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. We will now stop for a moment before we start the test. Please ask any questions now, because you mustn't speak during the test. Now look at the instructions for part 1. You will hear 5 short conversations. You will hear each conversation twice. There is 1 question for each conversation. For questions 1 to 5, put a tick under the right answer. Here is an example. How many people were at the meeting?
Were there many people at the meeting?
About 30.
That's not many.
No, but more than last time.
The answer is 30. So, there is a tick in box C. Now we are ready to start. Look at question 1. What music will they have at the party?
Are you going to bring your guitar to the party?
It's broken, I'm afraid, but you can play the piano for us.
I'm not good enough. Let's just play your new CDs.
All right. I'll bring the guitar another time.
Now listen again.
Are you going to bring your guitar to the party?
It's broken, I'm afraid, but you can play the piano for us.
I'm not good enough. Let's just play your new CDs.
All right. I'll bring the guitar another time.
Two. When will the man go on holiday?
I can't go on holiday in June because my parents are coming to stay with me then.
Why don't you go in August? It's a lovely month in the mountains.
July's better. There aren't so many people. So I'll leave on the 12th and come back at the end of the month.
OK. Then you'll be back for my birthday party in August. Now listen again.
I can't go on holiday in June because my parents are coming to stay with me then.
Why don't you go in August? It's a lovely month in the mountains.
July's better. There aren't so many people. So I'll leave on the 12th and come back at the end of the month.
OK. Then you'll be back for my birthday party in August. Three. What will the weather be like tomorrow?
It's very hot, isn't it?
Oh, yes, I love it. I hope it doesn't rain.
Well, it'll be cold and windy tomorrow.
Oh, dear. We never have hot weather for long.
Now listen again.
It's very hot, isn't it?
Oh, yes, I love it. I hope it doesn't rain.
Well, it'll be cold and windy tomorrow.
Oh, dear. We never have hot weather for long.
Four. What colour is Mary's coat?
Hi, Mary. What have you bought?
This coat. Do you like it?
Yes. Yellow looks good on you.
Do you think I can use my blue bag with it?
Your brown one will look better.
Now listen again.
Hi, Mary. What have you bought?
This coat. Do you like it?
Yes. Yellow looks good on you.
Do you think I can use my blue bag with it?
Your brown one will look better.
Five. What did the woman repair?
Hi. What have you done today?
You know that broken shelf above my desk? Well, I repaired it and then I went shopping.
What did you buy?
A new chair.
Now listen again.
Hi. What have you done today?
You know that broken shelf above my desk? Well, I repaired it and then I went shopping.
What did you buy?
A new chair.
This is the end of part one. Now look at part two. Listen to Sarah talking to a friend about her holiday photographs. What place is each person in? For questions 6 to 10, write a letter, A to H, next to each person. You will hear the conversation twice.
I've got some photos of my holiday in Spain here.
Did you go with your family, Sarah?
Yes. This is my mother walking in the mountains.
What lovely trees.
And this is my sister, Caroline, swimming.
Uh-huh.
She preferred swimming here to the hotel pool.
The sea looks very blue. And who's this, standing outside a castle?
Jack. But it's not a castle. It's a cathedral. It's one of the oldest in Spain.
And is this you, Sarah, buying bananas in a market?
Yes. That wasn't far from our hotel. The fruit was really cheap there.
And here's Peter eating.
Mm-hmm.
Is he in the garden of your hotel?
Actually, it's a restaurant near the cathedral. We often went there.
What's your father doing with the cassette recorder in this photo?
Oh, he loves history. He's in a museum here listening to information. That was his favourite day, because we also visited a castle in the morning.
They're great photos, Sarah.
Now listen again.
I've got some photos of my holiday in Spain here.
Did you go with your family, Sarah?
Yes. This is my mother walking in the mountains.
What lovely trees.
And this is my sister, Caroline, swimming.
Uh-huh.
She preferred swimming here to the hotel pool.
The sea looks very blue. And who's this, standing outside a castle?
Jack. But it's not a castle. It's a cathedral. It's one of the oldest in Spain.
And is this you, Sarah? Buying bananas in a market?
Yes. That wasn't far from our hotel. The fruit was really cheap there.
And here's Peter eating.
Mm-hmm.
Is he in the garden of your hotel?
Actually, it's a restaurant near the cathedral. We often went there.
What's your father doing with the cassette recorder in this photo?
Oh, he loves history. He's in a museum here listening to information. That was his favourite day, because we also visited a castle in the morning.
They're great photos, Sarah.
This is the end of part two. Now look at part three. Listen to Sue talking to her friend Jim about the new sports centre. For questions 11 to 15, tick A, B or C. You will hear the conversation twice. Look at questions 11 to 15 now. You have 20 seconds. Now listen to the conversation.
Have you been to the new sports centre, Jim?
Yes, Sue. It's not cheap, but it's big and light.
Does bus 18 go there?
That's right. It takes 15 minutes. Don't get bus 25, because you have to walk a long way.
I like doing sport early in the morning. Is it open at 7?
Yes. You can go there from 6, except on Sundays. Then it doesn't open until 9. The swimming pool has good hot showers. You have to bring your own towel, but you can get soap there. They don't make you wear a swimming hat.
Do they sell things to eat there?
Only sandwiches. They don't sell drinks. I usually take some fruit.
I'd love to go with you next week. How about Wednesday?
Well, I work until late on Wednesday. I'm free on Saturday, but it's too busy then. It'll have to be Thursday.
Okay. See you then.
Now listen again.
Have you been to the new sports centre, Jim?
Yes, Sue. It's not cheap, but it's big and light.
Does bus 18 go there?
That's right. It takes 15 minutes. Don't get bus 25, because you have to walk a long way.
I like doing sport early in the morning. Is it open at 7?
Yes. You can go there from 6, except on Sundays. Then it doesn't open until 9. The swimming pool has good hot showers. You have to bring your own towel, but you can get soap there. They don't make you wear a swimming hat.
Do they sell things to eat there?
Only sandwiches. They don't sell drinks. I usually take some fruit.
I'd love to go with you next week. How about Wednesday?
Well, I work until late on Wednesday. I'm free on Saturday, but it's too busy then. It'll have to be Thursday.
Okay. See you then.
This is the end of part 3. Now look at part 4. You will hear a man making a telephone call. Listen and complete questions 16 to 20. You will hear the conversation twice.
Hello. Could I speak to Diana, please?
She's not in at the moment. Can I take a message?
Yes, please. Tell her that Ian called from head office and we've booked her into the April Hotel for 2 nights.
Which hotel?
The April. You know, like the month.
Oh, yes.
I'm sure she'll like it. It's on Leith Street.
Could you spell that?
L-E-I-T-H. Leith Street.
OK, I've got that.
Now, she knows where the meeting will be, but she doesn't know the time. Tell her it will begin at 10:20 and finish at 4:30.
Right.
And could you tell her to take the book with her? She'll know which one. I'm sure she's finished reading it.
OK. Anything else?
Oh, yes. Please tell her I'll take her to the factory on Tuesday and she can speak to Mr. Brown on Wednesday morning.
All right. I'll make sure she gets the message.
Thanks very much.
Now listen again.
Hello. Could I speak to Diana, please?
She's not in at the moment. Can I take a message?
Yes, please. Tell her that Ian called from head office and we've booked her into the April Hotel for two nights.
Which hotel?
The April. You know, like the month.
Oh, yes.
I'm sure she'll like it. It's on Leith Street.
Could you spell that?
L-E-I-T-H. Leith Street.
OK, I've got that.
Now, she knows where the meeting will be, but she doesn't know the time. Tell her it will begin at 10:20 and finish at 4:30.
Right.
And could you tell her to take the book with her? She'll know which one. I'm sure she's finished reading it.
OK. Anything else?
Oh, yes. Please tell her I'll take her to the factory on Tuesday and she can speak to Mr. Brown on Wednesday morning.
All right. I'll make sure she gets the message.
Thanks very much.
This is the end of part four. Now look at part five. You will hear some information about a zoo. Listen and complete questions 21 to 25. You will hear the information twice.
Thank you for phoning Park Zoo. The zoo is open from Monday to Saturday from 9 in the morning to 7:30 at night and on Sundays from 10 to 5. You can stay in the zoo for 1 hour after closing time. The zoo is north of the city centre and you should take the train to North Station. It is a 5-minute walk from there. We have many interesting animals for you to see. But please note, the elephant house won't be open on the 3rd of May. I'm sorry, but you can't see the elephants that day. When you come, make sure you visit the zoo shop. There you can buy books, postcards and t-shirts. Everyone will want to wear a zoo t-shirt. An adult ticket costs £10, a children's ticket £5 and a family ticket £12. We hope you enjoy your visit to the zoo.
Now listen again.
Thank you for phoning Park Zoo. The zoo is open from Monday to Saturday from 9 in the morning to 7:30 at night and on Sundays from 10 to 5. You can stay in the zoo for 1 hour after closing time. The zoo is north of the city centre and you should take the train to North Station. It is a 5-minute walk from there. We have many interesting animals for you to see, but please note the elephant house won't be open on the 3rd of May. I'm sorry, but you can't see the elephants that day. When you come, make sure you visit the zoo shop. There you can buy books, postcards and t-shirts. Everyone will want to wear a zoo t-shirt. An adult ticket costs £10, a children's ticket £5 and a family ticket £12. We hope you enjoy your visit to the zoo.
This is the end of part five. You now have 8 minutes to write your answers on the answer sheet. This is the end of the test.